So in our survey of sexual selection, I've treated male-male competition and female choice as the norm. And indeed, the vast majority of species show careful females choosing between flamboyant or aggressive males. But as in so many different things in biology, there are numerous exceptions to the norm. A good example is this, the African Jinakana. This individual is quite brightly colored, quite aggressive, and she's a female. And female Jinakanas compete against other females for access to males. Yes, big, strong, brightly colored females competing for these rather drab little males who tend to the nests. So the female visits her husband every now and then, lays an egg, he looks after it, then she goes on to yet another husband, lays another egg there, he looks after it too. So a complete role reversal in the Jinakana. There's also such things as seahorses, where at mating, the female deposits her eggs into the male's pouch. He then fertilizes the eggs while they're in his pouch. She can then go off now and start eating like crazy, producing more eggs, and come back and mate with him again. Meanwhile, he's looking after the babies inside his body. Okay? So the male gives birth to live young, and these are monogamous. So a very, very different system than our norm of lions or birds of paradise. Perhaps the most interesting study, though, is of this, a very small little animal called a prairie vole. And it turns out that prairie voles are highly monogamous. All the other vole species are polygynous, so the males compete for lots of females as per usual. But in this one species called the prairie vole, they're highly monogamous. And the male, unlike in other species, is very, very faithful to his one wife. So faithful that the males refuse to mate with other receptive females even when their wives are away. And that's not anything you'd see in any other male rodent. It turns out that these different species of voles are hardwired in such a way to reflect these different mating habits. So on the left, we have our monogamous prairie voles, and these are brain scans showing areas that have high levels of certain hormone receptors, okay? And the tops are for females and the bottoms are for males. And we're going to compare this to the more normal kind of vole, the montane vole that's highly promiscuous, okay? And you'll notice that the prairie vole brain has a lot of receptors here for OT, that's oxytocin. And that's a hormone of love and affection. And the prairie voles are hardwired to feel lots of love and affection, whereas the montane voles aren't. And in the males, they have receptors for the male equivalent, which is called vasopressin. So they have a large region of their brain down here, very sensitive to vasopressin, whereas the montane vole doesn't. So these animals have a social system, one male with one female, and their brains reflect the devotion that they actually feel towards each other. But even though there are these exceptions, if you look across all the different species over and over again, you do see that same basic pattern inherent in sexual selection of male competition and female choice. So the male ego does seem to be pretty much the same in just about any species, whether it's peacocks, where the male just can't help himself but to show off at every opportunity, or in our friend the crab. There you are.